One of the attractions of Cambridge was that there was would be electron microscopy there. And one of the attractions, apart from people like Crick and Perutz, Kendrew, was the Hugh Huxley. Hugh Huxley was at that time the I think the best electron microscopist in the world. In fact, it's still a mystery to me. He hasn't got a Nobel Prize for the work on muscle, but he was the man, the best electron microscopist, when he died, technically superb, of course, with a very good mind and very good, brilliant mind, in fact. And so one of the attractions was that we knew what a virus shell should look like, so we should really be using electron microscopy, because X-ray diffraction takes a long time, many, many years, to solve a structure by X-ray crystallography. With electron microscopy, we should be able to see something. So Hugh Huxley gave a two-day course. I think you went to a two-day course, I mean, a private course.
Yes.
Now, the summer before in 61, I went to South Africa with a family for 3 months. And they had, I was in the physics department, the old department, James had died, James had retired by then. But they had some, I actually published a paper on X-ray diffraction of gums. I interpreted the X-ray fiber diffraction pattern. But there was also a microscope there. And I remember explaining to them how to do negative staining, which had been invented by Hugh Huxley and given a name by Sidney Brenner. And so I began doing, had to go into the room every day. So I began playing around with a technician, a man called Chick Fowle. Fowle was his name, F-O-W-L-E. He was called Chick, very good, very capable technician. And he showed me how to use an RCA electron microscope, which they had in the building. And I remember being very struck by it, that I began taking pictures. So I learned how to manipulate the microscope and so on. And I was also struck by something which I noticed then, which later stood me in good stead. These were negatively stained tobacco mosaic virus particles, which is the old war horse that we always used to look at. And it was negatively stained, which meant that the heavy metal stain was down the central hole. And the central hole appeared, well, it should be, well, it's black. It depends whether you're talking about the film or the print. It should appear dark, because no light should go through. And I noticed I was twiddling with the focusing knob, it went white. And I didn't know what this was, and I realized I must be changing the focus of the electron microscope. And that, I believe, was the origins, later on, some years later, when Ericsson came, of phase contrast defocusing to be able to image in electron microscopy transparent, or as they called, phase objects. So that was a pretty, again, one of these chance educational events, because I wouldn't have, it wasn't done by working out the theory, which people had worked out, when, which later on, of course, I followed the theory.